So, with the adventure of the Piute Peak under our belts, and the gas in the Jeep's tanks running nervously low, we opted for the quickest way down. And that proved to be the upper part of Jawbone Canyon Road that heads along St. John's Ridge, and then quite quickly and steeply down Garinger Grade, where the switchbacks drop 2,500 feet in just a couple of miles. You know, that was enough to actually get the brakes on the automatic transmission equipped Jeeps to heat up and smell. And I know we would have used low range to hold them back, but we were running mighty low on gas, remember? I even considered coasting, but thought better of it with the steepness of those grades. So what did we learn from all this? Something I already knew. Never head out on a trail without topping off your tank, even if you have to go out of the way to do it. And we also learned that this would probably be a better way to head up to the peak than the Piute Mountain Road. Hey, that wraps up our trip up Jawbone Canyon, Piute Mountain Trail, in and just outside of the Jawbone Recreation Area and Sequoia National Forest. Been an incredible adventure. The trail up Piute Mountain Trail is a pretty good trail. Easy enough to take in a pickup truck or a high clearance vehicle, stock SUV. Jawbone Canyon at the bottom is pretty good, but once you get up to that top and start coming down, it's best coming down because it's a tight, narrow little trail. Now, you know, you can get to this off of California State Highway 14, and you can turn at the Jawbone Canyon Station. They got all the maps there that we referenced that you would use to do this. We've stopped here right at the end of the day at the old pipeline that brought water into Los Angeles area from Northern California. And I'm gonna have to look up information, but it was designed and built by Mulholland. Yes, we probably know Mulholland Drive, but never know where Mulholland came from. It was that Mulholland that designed this, all steel pipe riveted together sometime in the 20s, and this thing brought water from Northern California down to LA without any pumps. And you can see here, it's pretty brainless that yes, water can run downhill, but if you look that way, it's pretty amazing that through the siphon effect that it went all the way up that other side of that canyon. Pretty amazing engineering feat. Now we have pumps and stuff to do it. You know what? Hey, that's it for our show. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. See you next week. God bless.